Today we're going to talk about how to memorize the unit circle. There are 16 important points on this, but I'm assuming you've already memorized these four, the intersections with the axes, so we're going to talk about the other 12. Let's start with quadrant 1. We have three important points that you have to memorize: the angle of pi over 6, pi over 4, and pi over 3. You might know them as 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees. You simply have to memorize what their sine and cosine are in order to be able to memorize anything else on this circle. So I'm going to give them to you. As you can see, there's some pretty interesting numbers. This guy's cosine is equal to this guy's sine, and vice versa, which is interesting. Since these two coordinates are really similar to each other, you should not mess them up. You can think about it that this guy is higher up on the circle, so his x value is less, and 1 is less than the square root of 3. You can also think about it, the way I think about it, is this is the cooler younger brother, and so he has the cooler number first, and then this is like the older brother, and he has like the more respectable number first. And then this is like the middle child, who no one cares about because they're easy to memorize. As you see, the rest of the points on this circle are certain variations of pi over 3, pi over 4, and pi over 6. They are reflections across the axes of these points, and they're quite interesting. They're interesting because they have the same magnitude for their cosine and sine. That is the key thing. The only thing that changes between this point and this point, or this point and this point, is the negativity and positivity of the cosine and sine. As this one is going over the y-axis, the cosine becomes negative. As it goes over the y-axis, the sine becomes negative and the cosine is negative. As it goes over the y-axis again, cosine is now positive and sine is negative. And then here it is. So it's good to memorize which quadrants have which signs. Also, as you can tell from these signs, you can tell the sign of the tangent. In this one, since both are negative, tangent's going to be positive. Same for this. In these two, we have two different signs, so sine is going to be negative. So now, of course, knowing that these are just reflections, we can easily determine the coordinates of any of these other 9 points. For example, in the second quadrant, the reflection of pi over 3, aka 2 pi over 3, is going to have a negative cosine and a positive sine. We've memorized that pi over 3 has 1/2 and then square root of 3 over 2. And so therefore, it's going to be negative 1/2 square root of 3 over 2. Same for any of these. This is the easy part. The hard part is when you don't have the unit circle, which is the goal, you want to memorize it, and trying to figure out what is the actual value of this point of reflection. Obviously, I've written them here, but I'm going to give you a trick for memorizing it. Let's start with quadrant 2. You just have to memorize quadrant 1. Here it is. In order to figure out the angle, the value of theta for coordinate 2, that is a reflection of one of these points, the numerator is going to be 1 less than the denominator, numerator being multiplied by pi. As you can see, this is 2 over 3, and 3 minus 1 is 2. This is 3 over 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, and this is 5 over 6. 6 minus 1 is 5. The third quadrant, the numerator is going to be the denominator plus 1 times pi. Now remember, these tricks I'm telling you only work with these three points. These are our key points. They're the really cool ones. That is what we're doing. Finally, the fourth quadrant. It is equal, the numerator is equal to 2 times the denominator minus 1 times pi all over the denominator. 6 times 2 is 12, 12 minus 1 is 11. 4 times 2 is 8, 8 minus 1 is 7, 3 times 2 is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. So basically, over here, this is what you have to memorize. To memorize all of these special points on the first rotation of the circle. Now, what if you get a number that you don't recognize? For example, today I was asked to find the sine cosine of tangent of this, 13 pi over 6. If you ever get a number that you realize is larger than one rotation, all you need to do is subtract a certain number of rotations. We can see that it's just over one rotation, so we're going to subtract 2 pi, which is one full rotation. We want it to have a common denominator, so it's going to be 12 pi over 6. This is equal to 2 pi, and now we get pi over 6. Therefore, this angle is coterminal with this angle. And I know this angle. Any angle value that is greater than one rotation, you want to find its coterminal angle. 19 pi over 4. This is obviously quite a bit of rotations. I'm going to estimate it's 2, so I'm going to subtract 16 pi over 4. This is equal to 2 full rotations. It's equal to 4 pi, which is 2 times 2 pi, 2 rotations. I want to get a number less than 8 pi over 4 because that is one full rotation. I want to get in that first rotation. And I get 3 pi over 4. Oh, I recognize this. This is the second quadrant, a reflection of pi over 4. I know that pi over 4 has the coordinates 1 over square root of 2, And it's the same for both. Obviously, pi over 4 is like really nice. And since it is in the second quadrant, I know cosine is negative. Finally, we should memorize the tangent. If you've memorized sine and cosine, you can probably figure it out. But I think that takes too long. Tangent is equal to sine over cosine. So we're just going to find the tangent of those 3 points in the first quadrant. And then we're going to apply the negativity and positivity rules. And this equals square root of 3. That's why I think that this angle is superior to pi over 6. I've seen a lot of people prefer pi over 6, and that really frustrates me. This one's really easy. It's always going to be some variation of 1. These are the numbers we got. This is always going to be some form of the square root of 3. This one's always going to be some form of 1. This one's always going to be some form of 1 over the square root of 3. Now let's look at the quadrants. The first one, first quadrant, double positive, it's going to be positive. Quadrant 2, 1 positive, 1 negative, is going to be negative. Quadrant 3, both negative, going to be positive, because you're dividing by 2 negatives equals a positive. Quadrant 4, also negative. You can see the pattern. Finally, a warning. If you're ever trying to find angle theta using sine, cosine, or tangent inverse, you should remember that the sine, cosine, and tangent will have 2 angles. And this is true for like any angle. There's always going to be 2 angles that have the same sine, 2 angles that have the same cosine, 2 angles that have the same tangent. And that concludes the unit circle.